हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई कैलाश कुमार सर अलोंग विथ माय को टीचर कृष्ण प्रिया मैम वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन दिस ऑनलाइन एडु क्लासेस ऑफ ब्रिलियंट पब्लिक स्कूल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विथ आर प्रीवियस टॉपिक ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर दैट इज सेंटेंसेस एंड दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ आर वीडियो इन दिस सीरीज। सो लेट्स प्रोसीड अहेड स्टूडेंट्स। वी वेरी वेल नो दैट The meaningful arrangement of words is known as a sentence. So, depending on the structure of these arrangements, the sentences are classified into three groups. They are complex sentences, compound sentences, and simple sentences. So, let's explore these three kinds of sentences in detail. Right, students? So, let us begin with the first sentence. That is simple sentence. A simple sentence has just one subject and predicate. It expresses a complete thought and has only one finite verb. So let us see. Simple sentence has one independent clause. It has one complete thought. It contains a subject and a predicate and one finite verb. And it may have many phrases and non-finite verbs. Here is one example. The boys went to the park. Here the boys is a subject, went is a finite verb. So this is a simple sentence. Now let us proceed further. Next we have compound sentence. Compound sentence contains two or more independent clauses, and these two independent clauses are joined by a coordinating conjunction. The coordinating conjunctions are for, and, nor, but, or, yet, or, so, and these two independent clauses are connected by a comma. Here is one structure: independent clause plus comma conjunction plus independent clause. So these two independent clauses are connected by a conjunction. Let us see the example. The boys went to the park but did not go to the zoo. Here the boys went to the park is one independent clause and the other independent clause is did not go to the zoo. So these two clauses are connected by a conjunction but. Let us proceed further. Next we have complex sentence. In complex sentence, one independent clause and one or more dependent clauses are there. The dependent clause or clauses begin with a conjunction and it can have a comma. Like, let us see the structure: independent clause plus conjunction plus dependent clause. This is an example. The boys didn't go to the zoo. This is independent clause. Because is a conjunction, and they went to the park. This is a dependent clause. So these two clauses are connected by a subordinating connector, because. So let us proceed further, students. Now we have transformation of sentences. Transformation of sentences means changing form of a sentence without changing its meaning. Like example, John is not my enemy. Jane doesn't hate John. Boys are not talkative. Girls cannot be silent. So let us move ahead and study in detail these transformation of sentences. When we transform a simple sentence to a compound sentence, we have to see these rules. They are changing a phrase into an independent clause by adding a subject and a finite verb. And second point, adding a coordinating conjunction like for, so, and, nor, or, but, yet. This is an example of changing a simple sentence to compound sentence. Quitting his job, he took up pottery. So this is an example of simple sentence. Now we are converting this, transforming this into compound by adding a conjunction and. He quit his job and took up pottery. Let us move ahead, students. When we convert compound sentence into simple sentence, we have to see these points. Convert one of the clause into a phrase and remove the conjunction. For example, I switched off the light and went to bed. This is a compound sentence. When we convert this into simple sentence, we do these things. Switching off the light, comma, I went to bed. So this is a very simple formula how to convert a compound sentence to a simple sentence. Next we have simple sentence to a complex sentence. So while transforming a simple sentence to complex sentence, we have to keep these things in mind. While changing phrases to clauses by adding subject and a finite verb, adding appropriate subordinating conjunctions or relative pronouns. So for noun clauses, we have to use these subordinating conjunctions like that, if, whether, as, if, then. And for adjective clauses, we have to use these subordinating conjunctions like who, that, which, whom, whose, as, etc. And for adverb clauses, these subordinating conjunctions are used. They are before, after, when, where, if, although, because. Let us see the examples. The helper polished his master's shoes. Actually, it should be the helper polished his master's shoes. The helper polished the shoes which belonged to his master. So here we have put more emphasis by adding a subordinating conjunction which, because it belongs to a person, that is the master. Let us move ahead, students. While transforming a complex sentence to simple sentence, these points to be kept in mind. By changing clause into a phrase, removing the subordinating conjunction. Example, nothing happened as I had planned. This is a complex sentence. It is connected by a subordinating conjunction as. Now, when we are changing this into a simple sentence, nothing happened according to my plan. So, this is a way you have to convert a complex sentence to a simple sentence. Now, transforming a compound sentence to complex sentence. By changing coordinating clauses to subordinating clauses. Second, by using subordinating conjunction instead of coordinating conjunction. Example is, I was running late, but I managed to catch the train. This is an example of compound sentence. Now we have to transform this into a complex sentence. Although I was running late, I managed to catch the train. Understood, students? Let us move ahead. Now, transforming a complex sentence to compound sentence. First, by changing subordinate clauses to coordinating clauses. Second, by using coordinating conjunction instead of subordinating conjunction. The example of complex sentence. If you do not enjoy life, you will regret it later. Now we have to transform this into compound sentence. You must enjoy life or you will regret it later. So, we have used coordinating conjunction or. instead of subordinating conjunction if. Right, students? So this was all about sentences and the transformation of sentences from simple sentence to complex and to compound sentence. So this much in this video, students. Thank you all. Have a blessed day. Have